हेलो अदिति, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? अदिति, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल? अवंतिका एंड अदिति,
सर ऑडिबल है। यस
ओके।
सर।
So shall we start? People will join in between. So shall we start? Because we have only 50 minutes of time for this meeting. So shall we start? So shall I start? Okay. So in the last class, we have seen Maxwell equation. I hope everybody is. I have told you to read the Faraday law, Ampere circuit law, Gauss law. So in this class, I will elaborate all this Maxwell equation and I will prove all the equations. So let's move on. So first of all, I will write all the Maxwell equation in differential and integral form, and after that, I will prove one by one every equation. So Maxwell equation. So here we will write differential form. Here we will write integral form. And here the significance of these equations. Significance. And after that, so in this week we will deal with Maxwell equation only, and we will prove all the equations one by one. Because these equations will come into a paper for like 10 or 12 marks. They will tell, please state and prove Maxwell equation. So you have to prove all the four equations which are given. So first equation was curl of E, that is electric field, equal to minus del B by del T. So this is the first equation, and when we will write the integral form of this equation, we will write like that. So integration. So for integral, maybe. So I will prove this equation. After that, after writing all the four equations, I will prove this. So integral form of this equation will be E dot dl equal to minus d phi by dt is equal to del v by del t dot ds. This is in integral form, and by Faraday law we are going to prove this equation. So first of all, I am writing all the four equations. After that, I will prove it. So you just need to note in this note in your paper, because when I will prove these equations, I will do in my ways. So if you will be with me, then you can understand it easily. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to understand it. So second equation was rho into H vector equal to J plus del D by del T. And when I will write it in the integral form, it will be like this. H into dl equal to I plus del T by del T into ds. If I'm writing here S in between of the integral form, it is that I am denoting the surface vector. So I am writing here S. C means I am denoting the, I am talking about the curl. So I am denoting it by C. And it has derived from Ampere circuital law. Ampere circuital law. Class is going on. I will call you sometime. So this is the second equation. So for third equation, curl of D, means divergence. I am talking about divergence equal to rho v. This is third equation, and when I will write it in integral form, I will write a surface integral of divergence equal to q, that is charge, is equal to rho v dv, and this I will derive from Gauss law. So this is the first, this is the second, this is the third. The fourth equation, that is a equal to zero. So and when I write it in integral form, for integral form, when I will write it, and this is derived from the magnetic charge equation. So these are the four equations which I am going to derive in this today's meeting, and please be with me, otherwise you will not able to understand. So one by one I will derive all these four equations. This is the four Maxwell equation, and in the paper it will come of like 10 or 12 marks, and you have to prove all these four equations. So it will definitely come of. So this is most important, because in EMFT from Maxwell equation only we are going to start. So if we are clear with the Maxwell equation, we will do all the application of the Maxwell equation will face later on. So I will start proving. So first of all, I need to prove this equation. So I'll start from here. So let's start. So first equation was curl of electric field is equal to minus del B by del T. So I have told you to study about Faraday law. So if you have not studied for them, I will tell you what is Faraday law. So basically Faraday law states that the induced EMF is equal to minus D by TT, means induced EMF, that is E is equal to minus B phi by DT. This is the law given by Faraday. It means that the rate of change of time of the magnetic flux through the circuit, this is the rate of minus D by DT is the rate of change over time of the magnetic flux through that circuit. So basically Faraday law is a basic law of electromagnetic. It states that the magnetic law means that how much induced EMF will be there, that much rate of change will be there. So we know that minus d phi by dt denotes that the rate of change means position is changing. It means that position is changing. So rate of change of flux because of the EMF is introduced. So what we can write is that because of this, how much the rate of change of flux is there. So we are denoting minus d phi by dt as a flux. The rate of change of flux because of EMF introduced. So when we will introduce the EMF, according to the Faraday law, when we will introduce the EMF, there will be change of rate of flux. This is all the basic of Faraday law. So based on this, we are going to derive this first equation, that is curl of E equal to minus d by dt. So as we know that the potential of the EMF that we will denote by VE. So the potential of the EMF will be denoted by VE, that is minus d phi by dt. Ritika, have you facing any problem, Ritika? Ritika, are you facing any problem? So please don't disturb in between if the class is going on. If you are not interested, you may leave in between. So please don't try to disturb. So as we know that the EMF, that is, this is EMF. So this is the potential of the EMF. So what I'm writing, what I'm denoting by this, that V is equal to minus d phi by dt. That is the rate of change of flux that we are knowing. So what we can write, so from according to this, VE is equal to, you just need to follow all the steps. Follow the steps, you will understand. So that will be equal to E dot dl equal to minus d by dt surface area of V dot ds. So I will elaborate this step from where this has came. So you don't need to worry about this. So see, we know that is E is equal to minus d phi by dt. That is the rate of change of So we are already knowing that V is equal to minus d phi by dt. So I am just substituting the value here, that is E dot dl equal to minus d by dt V dot ds. That I am writing in the integral form. So by partial derivation, what we write here, if we do partial derivation of this, what we will write here, that is E dot dl is equal to integral of surface area del V by del T dot ds. That we can write. So people are joining in between and they are studying with us. So after doing partial differentiation, we are getting this value. So after this, we will apply Stokes' theorem. Now by Stokes' theorem. So what does Stokes' theorem tell us? We can change the integral into the surface integral. Means this integral can be changed into the surface integral. That is what we are going to do. So wait for a second, I will add this also. She is already been added. Okay. So after this, by applying the Stokes theorem, what does the Stokes theorem say? We can change the line integral. The Stokes theorem states that the line integral is changed into the surface integral. So this is our line integral, that is E dot dl. So integral of E dot dl is our line integral. You have read Stokes theorem in mathematics, I guess. So this will be changed into the surface. Surface will be changed like this. So what I will write here, S, small s, curl of E dot ds. So this will be changed into the line integral by Stokes theorem. So what does Stokes explains that the line integral will be changed into surface. This is what line integral, and this will be changed into the surface when we will apply the Stokes theorem. So after changing this, what we will get? So we will get this equation here. So I will get here S same thing I will write here, and I will substitute the value of this line integral, that this value I will substitute here, because what I have done, I have changed this line integral into surface, and I am substituting the value of this. So what is the value of this? See, that is equal to S del B by del T dot ds. So when I will compare, by comparing both sides, what I will get? Curl of E is equal to minus del by del T. That is our first equation. I think many of you have not got it. I will explain one more time. So I have just given an overview that how that is very simple. You just need to know what is Stokes theorem and what does Stokes theorem says. So this is all the first equation is. I will tell you one more time. So if you are not writing, you can write it, because in any book, you will not get it in this kind of short form. So it will be very elaborated and it will be difficult for you to get it. So those who have not written, kindly write it. I will explain one more time. After that, I will take the doubt of all of you. So see how I have done this. So one more time, I will explain it from basic. So please kindly with me, because this will this four equation will come in the paper, any of the paper. You are electronic student, and wherever you will go, people will ask you what is Maxwell equation. So you can't run away from this. So what we need to prove, so please follow the step which I am doing. We need to prove curl of B is equal to minus del B by del T. This we need to prove. This we are going to prove. So I'll prove it. I'll show you how I'm going to prove. So I told you that according to the Faraday law, what is the Faraday law? The rate of change of flux will be there when the EMF will be introduced. That is, when we will introduce any EMF, there will be the rate of change of flux according to the Faraday law that we are already knowing. So from that, what we get? That EMF V equal to minus d phi by dt. That is minus d phi by dt is rate of change of flux. One second, I'll add. So according to the Faraday law, this is the induced EMF and this is minus d phi by dt. That is rate of change of flux. Rate of minus d phi by dt is rate of change of flux that we are getting according to the Faraday law. It means that because of this induced EMF that which we are introducing, there is the rate of change of flux. So what I will do, I'll write the potential of these two. So how I'll write the potential of these two? You just need to understand this step, after that everything will be clear. So potential of this will be written like this: E dot dl equal to minus d by dt, surface B dot ds. So we'll write this potential like this. I have written this potential, and after writing the potential, you just need to do partial differentiation, partial derivative of this equation. Partial derivative. After partial derivative, what you will get? You will get like this: E dot dl equal to minus s del b by del t dot ds. After doing partial equation, you will get this term. When you will get this term, your equation will be very simple, and after that you will do. So now next step will be you just apply Stokes' theorem. Now by Stokes' theorem, what does Stokes say? According to the Stokes, we can change the line integral into the surface integral. The line integral will be changed into the surface integral. Line integral will be changed into surface integral according to the Stokes theorem. So if you are having knowledge of mathematics, there is no rocket science there. You just need to apply that basic knowledge of mathematics. You will prove this equation very easily. So according to the Stokes theorem, what was the line equation which we have? This is our line equation, E dot dl. This is what line integral is there, and this will be changed into surface. So how it will be changed? I will put here S curl of E dot ds. So it will change into this. So according to the Stokes theorem, this line integral will change into this. So we have equation this one. So what I will write? The surface equation for this. So surface equation for this will be S, same thing I am writing here, this term I am writing here, because now we have changed this line equation into surface. I have written here, and the value, the same value I will put here, that is the equation one value I will put here only, surface of del B by del T dot ds. So I will just put this value. So now it is over. So what I next will be, by comparing this both term, what I will get? Curl into E equal to minus del by B by del t. So see, if you are having any doubt, please tell me. This equation, the first equation I have proved in front of you. Everybody please see, and if any point if you are unable to understand, please ask me. So this is the simplest. इससे ज़्यादा और simple आप नहीं कर सकते हैं. So if you are facing any step, you are facing any difficulty, kindly ask me. Because this is the first part of the curl of E equal to minus del E by del T. So if anybody is having any doubt, kindly ask me. Amisha Avantika, is it clear to you? Amisha Avantika.
Yes, sir, clear.
किसी भी पार्ट में अगर दिक्कत हो तो प्लीज आस्क, बिकॉज दिस इज गोइंग टू बी इन योर मिड टर्म एंड टर्म एवरीवेयर एंड वेर एवर यू विल गो दे विल आस्क अबाउट मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन एंड दे विल स्टार्ट बाय इन एनी इंटरव्यू दे विल स्टार्ट बाय व्हाट इज मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन डिराइव इट. So everywhere they will ask the derivation of this four equation. So if you are having any doubt in any step, ask me. This is the simplest. You cannot get in any book how this has been done. So kindly understand the steps of these. And if you are facing any difficulties, ask me. Jaya and Ritika Sakshi. Jaya Ritika Sakshi. You are facing any difficulty?
No, sir. Clear.
So one more thing I will tell you for your information. College has asked us to give the name of the student who have not joined 30% of class. So we have given the name of the student which we have not attended 30% of class, and your parents will be informed based on that. So if anybody is not attending now also, he or she will face the consequences, because now college has asked the name of the student to the faculties that who are not attending the class. So we have given. So the people who are not attending the class regularly, their parent will be contacted very soon. So this is the first equation which I have proved you. I hope everybody is clear with this. And if you are having any doubt, kindly ask me at any time. So this is and this type of equation will definitely come into your paper. So now I will prove the second equation. Now I'm going to prove the second equation. If you are not writing, please write it, because it will be easier for you after some time. If you will study the notes, you will directly get it. So if you are studying from any book or anywhere, sometimes it must be not clear to you. If you will make notes, it will be benefited for you only, because practice will makes you better. How many times you will write, that much time will be, that will be good for you. जितना बार लिखेंगे उतना बेहतर होगा. इसलिए जितना लिखिए खूब लिखिए, लिख लिख के प्रैक्टिस कीजिए. So now, second equation which I am going to prove is divergence of D, that is this line here. Divergence of D is equal to rho v. This equation I am going to prove now, the second form of Maxwell equation. So how to prove this? So we are already knowing from the Gauss law. So I will write here. If you have not studied, I have told you to study, because this thing will be included in your topic. When I will teach, this thing will come. So in if you have studied, you will get it easily. So according to Gauss law, the total electric flux passing through a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge which will be enclosed in the surface. So I will write here, according to the Gauss law, total electric flux. Total electric flux passing through a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed within the surface. It means that if we wanted to write it mathematically, so we can write it like that, that surface integral of equal to Q enclosed. So this is what Gauss law has been stated like this. This is what Gauss law is. If I wanted to write in mathematical term, so it basically how many total electric flux which will pass through a closed surface, that will be equal to 1 by epsilon naught about the total one by epsilon naught times the total charge will be there. So what I have written here, so by mathematically we will write the Gauss law like this. So see, or we can write like this: D is equal to epsilon naught into E. That is 1 by epsilon naught E times. It is written. So what we will write here? Epsilon naught into E. So, or I can write like this. It can be written like this only. E dot BS is equal to Q by epsilon naught. So anything that I can write. So if it is clear, so you can do the next step very easily. So since we know that rho v is the volume charge density, what is this? This is volume charge. Rho v is the volume charge density. We are aware of this. So we can denote Q by like this. So in this, after this step, let's suppose this is our first equation. So now it is over. If you do like up to this step, your problem is over. So what I will do, I will just put this Q into the first equation. Put this Q into first equation. That is here. What I will get here? So I'll get here. So after putting this in first equation, what I will do into E. I have put the value of Q here. So after putting, so we are aware of divergence theorem. By divergence theorem, so earlier what we have seen, that Stokes theorem, that line integral will be changed into the surface integral. But in this, the divergence theorem, surface integral will be changed into volume. Surface integral will be changed into volume. Earlier line was changed into surface. Now surface has been changed into volume. It means that surface, that is this will be changed into volume. So this we have to change this into volume. So what I will write here? S d dot d s, that is our surface integral, and I will change it into volume, that is triple v dot d dot dv. So this is what I have done. So this is changed into the volume. This is our surface integral, and this surface integral is changed into the volume integral. And now this value I am substituting here only. This term will be substituted here only. This I will substitute here, because this has become our volume integral. So what I will get, what I will write here, triple V dot dv equal to volume rho v dv. So after comparing, what I will get here? Divergence of v is equal to rho. Hence it is true. I'll do it one more time. So you just need to know one or two, three steps, and after that you will get it easily. So this is very simple. I'll tell you one more time. Please kindly concentrate on this. If anybody has not got at any point, I'll do it one more time. So let's start it one more time. So what, see. So see, what we need to prove is, that we need to prove that is divergence of B is equal to rho V. So according to the Gauss law, what we know, that the total electric flux passing through a closed surface will be equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed within the surface. So according to the Gauss law, we are aware of this. So when we will write the mathematical expression for this statement, what I will write here, that is S D dot DS is equal to Q enclosed. So, or we can write like this, that divergence and E is equal to epsilon naught into E. Or we can write like this, that E dot if you are writing in the surface term, E dot ds is equal to q by epsilon naught. This is what Gauss equation in mathematical form. So if you are aware of Gaussian equation, now our problem is solved. So what I am going to do? So since we know that rho v is the volume charge density, what is the rho v? Volume charge density. Volume charge density. So how to denote the volume charge density? So we can denote the volume charge density q is equal to rho v dv. We'll denote it like this. And what I'm going to do, I'll just put this q value of q in the equation one. That is our this value. So I will put this value in equation one here. This is our equation one. So now the value of q will be this one. So when I will substitute the value of this in the equation one, what I will get here? I will get here S V dot ds is equal to, instead of q, what I will write here? Volume charge density. Volume charge density denoted by triple integral form into rho v dv. This is the triple integral form. So now I have substituted the value of q here. After substituting the value of, I have to apply the divergence theorem. So I think everybody is clear up to this step. Now I will apply the divergence theorem here. So by divergence theorem, surface integral will change into volume integral. Earlier line integral has changed into the surface integral. Now surface integral will be changed into the volume integral. So what I will write here? So this will be changed into the volume integral. So the volume integral for this will be our new volume integration. Now just substitute the value here. What you will get after substituting the value? So I'll write this same term here only. And this value is equal to this one. This one. This value is equal to this one. This is equal to this one. That is rho v. Now we have to compare these two values. After comparing, what you will, by comparing these two values, what you will get here? Divergence of V is equal to rho V. Hence rho. So please refer to every step and tell me in which step you are getting any doubt. I'll try to elaborate those steps. Please refer all the steps and tell me in which steps you are getting doubt. So if every, so kindly see the all the steps and tell me in which you are getting, if you are facing any difficulties in any of those steps, please tell me. Because this step, these are the equations which you are going to prove in your paper, and that will definitely come. In any paper, you must be in any kind of paper, or you are an electronic student and now you are in third year, so you must be aware of Maxwell equation and how to get this. So if you are aware of basic mathematics, you can do it easily. Up to second semester, I think you have studied mathematics, calculus and all. In that calculus, we have studied Gauss theorem, Stokes theorem. So now the use of these theorems are coming here. So if you are aware of the basic knowledge of mathematics, you can solve the problem very easily. So if you are facing any difficulty, kindly tell me. These are all the equations which I have proved you. So how to get the, by the help of the divergence theorem and the, by the help of the, if you are aware of the Gaussian theorem, you can write the equation directly. And just after writing the equation, you need to apply the divergence theorem. That is all. And the last step, you need to compare all these two values. After comparing, you'll get the equation, final equation, you'll get easily. So please tell me if you are finding any difficulty in any of those steps, kindly tell me. So today we have proved two Maxwell equations. We have total of four equations in differential and integral form. And now we have proved two equations and two more equations are remaining here. So if you are having any doubt in these two equations, please tell me. Because see, this is not an one way conversation. You need to means give me answer or support me. Otherwise, how I will understand that you are finding any difficulty or not? So I think it is very easy. It is very simple. If you read in any book, so it will be little bit complicated. But if you learn these steps, it will be easy. So you just need to learn the Gauss theorem, divergence theorem, Stokes theorem. That's all. That is what the question is. So should we move on? Should we? Okay. So we'll go to our third equation. So I'll request everyone to join meeting one more time, because this meeting will be end in 5 or 10 minutes. So I'll restart the meeting one more time and you will join it. So we will get extra 30 minutes for that session. Otherwise, this meeting will be completed in between and will not complete all this Maxwell equation. So I'll request everyone. So please leave this meeting, and after 5 minutes I'll join this meeting in the same link. So I'm now, for the time being, I'm closing this link. So after 2 or 3 minutes, you just join it. I'll start one more time, because this meeting will be, I think it will probably finish in 5 or 10 minutes. So please leave it.